In this lesson, we will see how to model one-to-one relationships to create an extension table and display it on the screen. What we want to do is to create a new entity. So let's go here into the data tab. And this entity will be the shipping details. And let me just open here the diagram and add the shipping details to the diagram. And let's add an attribute to this entity, which will hold all this detail information about the shipping of the order. And since this is a large information, let me set this length to 5,000 characters. And now I want to make these shipping details an extension table of the order entity. And to do this, what I'm going to do is to actually change here the identifier of the shipping details. By default, you already know that this is an integer and auto number, and I'm going to change this data type to be order identifier. And you'll notice again here in the diagram, when I select order identifier now, that a relationship, a one-to-one relationship, is created between the order and the shipping details entities. This one-to-one relationship allows us to store more information about a record in a different entity. Whenever we create a new record in this shipping details entity, we will need to set this ID programmatically, as this is no longer an auto number. Okay, one final thing that I want to do here in my entity is to make sure that when I delete an order, that the shipping details that extends that order is also deleted. And I'm going to do that by changing here this delete rule to delete. So whenever you delete an order, if there is a shipping details record associated with it, it will be automatically deleted. You don't have to add any extra code to delete the shipping details. You can also check in the reference documentation, just press F1 here on this property, the other delete rules that exist and how you can use them to model your information in your applications. So we're pretty much done modeling the shipping details. Let's go back to the order details screen. And now we want to display this one-to-one relationship. And the first thing we'll have to do, for us to show the details here in the screen, we will need to fetch them from the database. So let's go here into the preparation. Let's open here the getOrderByID aggregate, and let's add in this aggregate the shipping details detail property. So this guarantees that we are fetching the shipping details from the database. Let's go, and by the way, this automatically added here a condition, and this means that we will get the order and the shipping details if there is a shipping detail. So we'll get the orders with or without the shipping details. And now that we fetched the information from the database, we can go back here into the form and add this attribute to the form. So this will come after the client attribute there. And well, it seems that I have an error in my application. Let me just double check here in the true change pane. There's an invalid data type. So let me just double click here on this error. And okay, I know what it is. It means that in this action, the creator update, this is expecting to receive an order entity. And in this case, our form now holds an order and a shipping details entity. So I need to be a little bit more specific here and say that I'm going to actually send the information about the order to create the order in the database. Now, once I create this order, I want to create the shipping details. So this is where we're going to use the output of this action to create our shipping details. So let me just add here an assigned node here into the flow, and I will need to set here in the form the ID. Remember that I said that once this shipping details record is created, we need to set this ID programmatically, since this is no longer an auto number. So I'm going to set the ID, and I'm going to use the output of the create or update order. This action returns the identifier here, this attribute, of the record that was just created or updated. In this case, this will return the order identifier that we need to use to assign to the shipping details. Okay, so we set the record of the shipping details. Now we can send it to the database. And again, we will use the create or update shipping details action. And here in the source, use the record of the form. And we need to be specific. This is just the shipping details that we are sending to the database. Okay. We're done, let's publish, but before pressing the one-click publish, let me just add here a breakpoint, because I want to test this. I want to test this with the debugger, so let's publish. And let's start the debugger. And let's open the application in the browser. Okay, let's go into our order. And there we have the information. Now let's add here some details. Let's say that deliver between 9 a.m. and 1 p.m. Let's save. And there, so we already executed the create or update order. Let's look here that the create or update order returned ID number 1. Okay, so this is the same as the input parameter because we are editing this order. We assign that value here to the order form record shipping details ID. So we assign there number 1. And now we are going to create or update the shipping details. Let me just step over. And the create or update shipping details will also return ID 1, which is in fact the order ID. Let me just continue, go back to the browser. There we have it. The information is stored in the database. That's it.